Friendly Neighborhood Gamer here, and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the aspects of prefabulated amulite. Additionally, I'm going to be talking about 6 glitches that are currently working as of right now. Really quick, also, I want to say thank you to everyone who has liked and subscribed to my channel. I really appreciate it, so thank you very much. As long as you're doing that, the content will keep coming. Thank you. And other than that, let's get straight into the video. So first glitch that we have the disarm glitch. I'm going to be showing you 3 locations here where you can disarm some things to get some junk, ammo, and XP. So over here at the Pleasant Valley Ski Resort, you can disable all these flamethrower traps to get a bunch of junk, ammo, fuel, rubber, and whatever else it gives you. Currently for this method, I just use my finger and spam tap to disarm, and it works very well. If you have an auto clicker, you can evil double and triple the amount you would get by doing it with your finger. So you can follow like I did. You can go up to each of these flamethrower traps and disarm them. I think there's about 7 or 8 of them in this area, so you can get a nice amount of fuel, rubber, and I think it's aluminum that you get for the junk. I'm not going to go to all of them just for the purpose of shortening this video because I don't want to keep you here long. So let's move on to the next location. The next location we have is, of course, Pylon V30. Shit. Anyways, come to this location and you can disarm all these Tesla coils if you spam your disarm button fast enough, but make sure you have the home defense perk card. I forgot to mention that earlier on in order to disarm these. Again, make sure you have the home defense perk card on, else you will not be able to disarm these. Anyways, the laggier the server, the better chances you are you're going to be able to disarm this as many times as you want. And on to the next location. This location is, of course, the White Springs Golf Club. So what you're going to want to do here is you're going to want to make the way like I do. You're going to want to run up this little driveway or path or whatever you want to call it. And then you're going to come up on this bus, not that one. So keep running past all these cars and it's going to be close to the White Springs place. So you're going to come right into this bus here and you are going to see this trap. You can disarm this trap here, the tripwire, and then you're going to make your way to the back of the bus and you can spam disarm these grenades and get pretty much a large sum of grenades. If you hop servers, you can get as much grenades as you want. You can sell them or do whatever the hell you want with them. I don't care. And I'll show you right here, just from those 2 disarms from those grenades, I have about, I think it was 41 grenades total from doing that just on both of those. Next up, of course, we still have the photo mode glitch, which has been around for quite some time, but it is still currently working in the game. Very useful to get to places that you normally wouldn't be able to get. So use this while you can because it is a very useful glitch. And all you have to do for that is basically go up to a door, press start, get into photo mode, exit out, and walk forward, and you will go through the door. It doesn't usually work on walls very well, but it mostly works on doors that have an entryway behind them. Next up, one of the OG glitches that is still also working is the Power Armor Take No Radiation Damage glitch. All you have to do for this is go to the edge of a nuke zone if you don't like wearing power armor. Place your power armor down right where you're taking radiation damage and right where you're not. Just get it as close to the edge as possible, get into the power armor, and then you're going to walk into the nuke zone, and then you're going to get out of your power armor, and you will take no radiation damage. Now, of course, next up we have the ammo glitch. This works like the old one. You're going to fire a shot out of your primary weapon, switch to a secondary weapon with a large ammo capacity, and then you are either going to drop your weapon or store it. I will show you both methods here. I'm going to drop this weapon after I fired it and switch to my secondary, and then I'm going to pick it back up and as you can see, the ammo will be glitched into the mag. So once you drop it, just pick it back up, get back to that weapon, and boom. As you can see, I have 499 in my mag. Still works like a charm. Now I'm going to show you the second method where you will be storing it instead of dropping it. So shoot like you normally would for the ammo glitch, and then you are going to store that weapon, and then you are going to put it back into your inventory, and then you are going to grab it back into your personal inventory, and it will work like a charm, as you can see here in just a sec. Once back into your inventory, switch to the weapon, and voila, there it is, 499 in the mag. Still works like a charm. And of course, next up, we have the magazine glitch. Now, I've heard a lot of people not being able to get this to work, but it still works like a charm for me. All you do, go up to it, read it, get into photo mode, exit out of photo mode, and then you can spam click it. And I'll even show you here in my inventory in just a sec that it is adding up in my inventory. It still works like a charm for me, and this was able to do on my first try. So as you can see, I'm pressing the read spam on it to pick it up, and I will show you here that I am getting a mass amount of these magazines into my personal inventory. So use this while you can. I'm actually very surprised that this hasn't been patched yet, or maybe I'm just lucky, but it still works for me regardless. Next up is one of our favorites, which is the ward glitch. All you have to do for this is find one of the things on the ground that you would have to normally get for the quest. You can find this in a public server, which I highly recommend because it seems to appear better in a public server than it does a private. Once you find one of these items, go to the stash and store it. It doesn't matter if the quest is active, although it seems to work better for me if the quest is active when I store the item. And then once you store the item, you're going to leave. Once you leave, then you're going to come back in, make sure you got the turret circuit board, and then you are going to talk to Ward and choose the first dialogue option. You'll know you have done it right when you stash the item and then leave the server, because you'll get a turret circuit board usually in your junk. If you see that there with a quest marker next to it, that means you've done it right. Once you've done that and gotten back into the server, make sure you grab the item that you found on the ground. Once you have both items in your inventory, you are going to talk to Ward. Now, once you talk to Ward, make sure you choose the first dialogue option, and make sure you let him finish his dialogue. Don't skip it, because it can glitch out the quest. Once you have received the rewards from Daddy Ward, you are going to get both of your items, you're going to go back, and store the item that you originally picked up. Make sure that you store it, and then you're going to leave the server, and you can do it all over again, rinse and repeat. Now I believe Glitch Unlimited did a video on this a while back. I will link to that in the description of this video. I will leave this video going for just a sec just to show you that it does work and can be repeated. I actually did it today, and then yes, it does work.
Sorry to hear that. I wish there'd been another way. We'll get this reinstalled in the turret right away. Good job.
Thank you so much for watching the video, and hopefully you found this helpful. I didn't include a few glitches just because there's a ban wave going around, and I didn't want to include some of the riskier ones that are currently out there. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this, and we will catch you next time. Press the damn subscribe button already.